Hello students, myself Mrs. Sabina Pathan welcomes you all to my YouTube channel SVP Class. Dear students, we are at the second chapter of our OCM subject, that is Functions of Management. And here in this video, we are going to study importance of organizing function of management. So do watch the entire video to understand each and every point from this topic. And do not forget to like, share and subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification of the latest videos. So let's begin with today's topic. Dear students, before beginning with the importance of organizing, I would like to give a small recap of meaning of organizing. Organizing is one of the important functions of management which follows planning. In this function, all the resources are identified, bring it together and are to be arranged systematically to achieve the goal. In a business organization, management decides the ways and means to achieve what has been planned by organizing all the resources. Students, we have already discussed meaning and definition in detail in the earlier lecture. Watch the earlier video too for a complete understanding of the topic. I have shared a link of the earlier video in the description box. Now, let's begin with today's topic. Here, we will study what is the importance of organizing function of management. See, there are some points which explains us importance of organizing. First one is, facilitates administration as well as operation. Second, brings specialization. Third one, defines the jobs properly. Fourth, clarifies authority and responsibility. And fifth one is, establishes coordination. Sixth point is, helps for effective administration. Seventh, helpful for growth and diversification. Eighth one, creates sense of security. Ninth point is, scope of innovation. And tenth point is, helps in optimum utilization of resources. Now, let us study all the points one by one in detail. First point is, facilitates administration as well as operation. Organizing process leads to identify and to group the activities. Grouping and assigning the activities is the task of administration, whereas processing according to it is operational activity. Here, in the process of organizing, all the activities are identified and group them together. The important task like grouping and assigning work to the employee is to be performed by administration department. Especially it is performed by the managers. They have the responsibility of assigning work to the employees, and processing the work is an operational activity. Thus, organizing facilitates administration as well as operation of the organization. Proper grouping of the tasks and the employees leads to increase in production and reduction in wastage. Duplication of work is restricted and effective delegation becomes possible. Here again, if there is a proper grouping of the work to the employees, it leads to increase in production and reduction in wastages of resources. Second point is brings specialization. Organizational structure is a network of relationships in which the work is divided into units and departments. Division of work helps in bringing specialization in various activities of organization, which leads to increase in organizational efficiency. Here, in the process of organizing, there is proper division of work among different departments. The work is divided to the employees based on their skill and expertise knowledge. So the employees perform the work in which they are expert, which ultimately helps to bring specialization, and it also helps to improve organizational efficiency. Third point is, defines the jobs properly. Organizational structure helps in putting right men on right job, which can be done by selecting people for various departments according to their qualification, skill, and experience. This is helping in defining the jobs properly, which clarifies the role of every person. Here, students, in an organization, there are three levels: top level, middle level, and lower level. At each level, right persons are appointed based on their qualification, skill, and knowledge for the respective position. So the person who is expert in a particular field, that work is to be assigned to them, which helps them to clear their role, and it also helps to bring efficiency in them. So this organizing function helps to define the job of an employee properly. Fourth point is, clarifies authority and responsibility. Organizational structure defines the role to every manager. This can be done by delegating the authority to every manager and clarifying the way he has to exercise those powers, so that misuse of powers does not take place. Well-defined jobs and responsibilities helps in bringing efficiency into managers' working, which helps in increasing productivity. Here, in an organization, managers have given authority or power to handle various things. Role of every manager are clearly stated with them well in advance, which helps to avoid the misuse of powers. Managers are able to work more effectively since their authority and responsibilities are clear, which helps to increase productivity of an organization. Now, fifth point is, establishes coordination. This function helps in establishing coordination among different departments of organization. It creates clear-cut relationships among positions and ensures mutual cooperation among individuals. Coordination or synchronization between all departments and different level of managers is important for smooth functioning of organizational activities. Here, systematic organization of work leads to coordination among different departments in the organization. In an organization, if there is a proper division of work and role is defined to each employee as per their position, then the work of the organization will run smoothly as the positions are already cleared with them. This also ensures mutual cooperation among different levels of managers as well as employees. Sixth point is, helps for effective administration. This function determines different positions departments, activities, and the roles are clearly structured. The utmost care is taken while placing right person in the right job with right authorities and responsibilities. It is achieved through division of work and delegation of authorities. This all leads to efficient and effective administration. Here, students, to make the administration effective, different positions or departments, activities, and role of each employees are clearly stated with them and well structured. Even the person who is skillful and right one for the particular position are to be appointed to bring specialization. So for example, in the accounts department, accountants or sometimes CS are also appointed. So if the expert persons will work at different departments, the organization becomes more efficient and effective. Now, seventh point is helpful for growth and diversification. Clearly defined roles and responsibilities, coordination among all levels of management personnel, and use of appropriate control techniques bring efficiency at workplace and organization grows well. So this point is very simple. Here, if the roles and responsibilities are clearly stated well in advance, and if there is a coordination at all levels in the organization, even new and updated methods are used in production process, these all directly bring efficiency, and it ultimately organization grows well. And this is possible only when the organization structure is well defined. Eighth point is, creates sense of security. Organizational structure clarifies the job position and clearly states the duties and responsibilities of everyone. Clarity in jobs and powers helps in increasing mental satisfaction, and it creates sense of security among the employees. Here, if the job position and work is clearly stated to employees, they feel secure at their workplace. Employees should be mentally satisfied with their work. There should not be frequent removal from their position. If the employees feel secure at workplace, they will work more efficiently for the organization. Therefore, there is a need of proper organization of work to bring a sense of security among employees. Ninth point is scope of innovation. Organizing function clears the roles and activities to be performed by the employees by using their new ideas, which provides enough space to the manager to develop talent and flourish the knowledge. This scope for innovation into adopting new changes in methods of work is possible only through a set of organizational structures. Dear students, innovation means newness, something creative. Here, in an organization, employees are allowed to work by using their new ideas, which provides space for the manager to develop new talent. Even manager should always welcome the ideas given by employees to bring newness in the work. 10th point is, helps in optimum utilization of resources. This function provides different jobs to different employees according to the job specification. Due to this, specialization of work becomes possible. This right workforce utilizes other resources at its optimum level so that desired results are achieved within defined period. Very simple point here, students. See, in an organization, if the right person at right place is appointed, it brings specialization. And due to specialization, these employees will use other resources at optimum level. Means they will not make any wastages of resources. They will try to use minimum resources and bring maximum output. So students, we have seen how organizing function plays very important role in the process of management to make the organization more efficient. I hope all points are clear to you. I have shared a link in the description box to solve the questions based on this topic. Just click on the link and solve the test and you will get immediate score of your test. Do like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel and do press the bell icon to get the notification of the latest videos. Thank you for watching and stay connected with me for more videos.